I'm Fiona Forbes for Investment Pitch Media. Great Atlantic Resources has expanded its Glen Elg Vanadium property by means of additional mineral claim staking, which approximately tripled its size to the current area of approximately 3,500 hectares. The property is located within southwest New Brunswick, approximately 17 kilometers east of the town of St. Stephen, and approximately 15 kilometers northwest of the company's Mascarene property, which hosts multiple mineral occurrences with cobalt, copper, nickel, zinc, lead, gold, and or silver. The property hosts vanadium and titanium mineralization occurring within the Beau-Quebec-Gabbro complex. The Glen Elg property is located immediately south of the Clarence Stream Gold Project of Galway Metals, with a portion of the northern boundary bordering Galway's Clarence Stream Gold Project. Galway reported an NI 43-101 resource estimate for the project during 2017, reporting total measured plus indicated resources of 6,178,000 tons at 1.96 grams per ton gold for 390,000 ounces of gold, and total inferred resources of 3,409,000 tons at 2.53 grams per ton gold for 277,000 ounces of gold. Earlier this year, Galway reported a new gold discovery at the Clarence Stream Gold Project, with one hole reported to intersect 7.3 grams per ton gold over a 36.7 meter core length. Readers are cautioned that mineralization at the Clarence Stream Gold Project and at Great Atlantic's Mascarene property are not necessarily indicative of mineralization within the Glen Elg Vanadium property. Great Atlantic's recent staking significantly expanded the Glen Elg property to the west-northwest, covering additional ground reported to be underlain by the Silurian Beau-Quebec-Gabbro complex. Areas of reported magnetic anomalies and three gold occurrences as reported within the New Brunswick Department of Energy and Resource Development mineral occurrence files. Such magnetic anomalies are interpreted by management to be targets for the vanadium and titanium bearing magnetite-rich layers within the complex. The company reported historic bedrock grab samples from the layered Beau-Quebec-Gabbro complex within the Glen Elg property returned significant levels of vanadium and titanium. Historic bedrock grab samples were also reported to return significant levels of gold, cobalt, and bismuth. A reported 1990 bedrock grab sample of quartz sulfide breccia from one of the gold occurrences was reported to return 1.33 grams per ton gold. Polymetallic veins are reported within the Glen Elg property, with a grab sample collected during 2006 reported to return 2.6 grams per ton gold and 0.65% cobalt. A 2013 grab sample from a sulfide vein was reported to return 14 grams per ton gold, 1.28% bismuth, and 0.12% cobalt. Both samples are reported within the southeast region of the property within the company's original mineral claims. A 2018 grab sample collected by the company from a magnetic layer in the Beau-Quebec-Gabbro complex returned 0.188% vanadium, 10.3% titanium oxide, and 25.71% iron. Another 2018 bedrock grab sample collected by one of the company's option partners from the same southeast region of the property was reported to return 0.234% vanadium, 7.34% titanium, and 28.8% iron. A previous sample from this region in 2013 was reported to return 16.5% titanium. The Glen Elg property has seen little exploration, and management cannot find any evidence of historical drilling within the property. Great Atlantic, with a number of projects throughout the Atlantic provinces, is building the company utilizing a project generation model with a special focus on the most critical elements on the planet that are prominent in Atlantic Canada: antimony, tungsten, and gold. The shares are trading at 41 cents. For more information, please visit the company's website, greatatlanticresources.com. Contact Christopher R. Anderson, President and CEO, at 604-488-3900. I'm Fiona Forbes for Investment Pitch Media.